Yo, what's up? We are now at Ayantedal, and behind me here I have the Polestar 2. Yes, he's back. This is a different Polestar. Shout out to Anders who lent me this car. It's not from Polestar directly, it's from one of my followers. And I can show you the wrap. This car is originally black, but it has been wrapped in I'm not sure what kind of color it is, but it's pretty cool. I mean, I have to say, the Polestar is a nice looking car, a nice Volvo. Oh, I see. Would be great to have some mud flaps. Oh, let me change. There we go. There's slightly better. Yeah, mud flaps would be nice. You see, you can say, well, mud flap doesn't look pretty on the car. Well, does the car look pretty now? But yeah, so the reason why I'm going to test the Polestar is that there's been a recent update, they call it the February update, that increased the capacity of the battery, actually using more of the bottom buffer of the battery. So I measured 73.5 kilowatt hour on it before. We are charging up now. We're gonna try to drive 90 kilometers per hour and measure again. And there's also another update, which is that supposedly they have updated the speed. The charging curve has been improved. Okay, not much to see there. It's pretty hard to see, actually. But I'm gonna show you inside. All right. It still looks like the old one before. This one doesn't have the leather option. So I wonder how much I will sweat in the seat today. But, you know, from the factory, this part here is just glossy and it gets scratches all the time. Now the owner, he put on some very common for Polestar owners to wrap this center part. You see, this one is still kind of glossy, so now it is better, it doesn't scratch that much. So right now we are charging. Oh, it goes pretty slow. We're gonna charge 100%. It should finish in 5 minutes with 98. We need to charge 100% before we do the test. So other than that, Harman Kardon speakers, nice interior. Yeah, I still feel like it's a little bit cramped here, but I just measured here. USB-C is Schnell. It allows fast charging. I was receiving 1.6 amp. Yeah, that's pretty fast on the phone. So let's wait a little bit more and then we go for the test. All right, we are done. And the nice feature is that we are still preheating the car and it's still pulling power from the charger, 2 kilowatts. But we're gonna unplug now, reset everything, and start driving. We are on the move, and right now we have to drive at 94 kilometers per hour to match the 90 speed. Consumption a little bit high because today is quite windy. We have headwind right now, but at least nice weather. What was the temperature again? 3 degrees Celsius. Yeah. So man, nice weather. Oh, I like it. So now we just have to drive it down to almost zero. We are now at Rudshøgda, and we're gonna check distance. So according to Google Maps, which is the answer to everything, then the trip meter should be 91.1 kilometer. Right on the bridge, it is 91.1 kilometer. This is Swedish precision, yeah. Okay, let's go back. Right, so far we are at 70%, and I think I did some rough calculation, and it seems like we still have around 73 kilowatt hour, which is the same as before, but okay, I want to show you a bug here. The car claims that we have driven 91 kilometers per hour average speed, but if you do the math based on the time and the distance, you will see that the real average speed is actually 88 kilometers per hour. So this has been a well-known bug. Well, I mean, for me, I know about this bug, that it actually calculates incorrectly the average speed. So many people don't know this, but it consistently shows you 3 kilometers per hour higher average speed. So yeah, but okay, so far so good. We're driving now back again towards Dahl. And then we have to do another loop somewhere. We have now driven 212 kilometers And based on the numbers right now, it seems like we have only about 72.5 to 72.8 kilowatt hour available, and that is exactly the same as previous run. When I tested it last year, it was 72.8 kilowatt hour. So right now it doesn't look like we have more capacity, even though it was claimed that there was more capacity. But you know, there's only one way to find out, which is to verify it by doing the test here. We are now at 11%, and you see we start getting power limit. You see this area there to the right, that's power limit, and it actually started already at 12%. So this is an indication that the battery might be cold-ish. So it's not relevant for this test, but when I do the charging test, I need to heat up the battery a little bit more. So stats so far, all right, 320 kilometers driven. Consumption only 204, which is not too bad considering that it's 3 degrees Celsius outside. So yes, we're gonna drive a little bit more. I want to drive it kind of low, drive it to like, let's say 2-3% before I end it, to get the most accurate measurement. Ah shit! You see, we are at seven. Wait, can I? Okay. We are at 7% and we have turtle mode and the power limit is getting pretty low now. Oh, let's slow down. And then suddenly, once you have turtle mode, then Polestar, they have chosen that, then you are not allowed to use cruise control. So I have to drive manual now, try to cruise at 93-94 kilometers per hour. But I feel like bailing out now because I don't want to drive too far without cruise control and turtle mode. So let's just head back to Dahl, if we can make it there. Ah, 6% now, 6%! We are back at the starting point, Ionity Dahl, and we drove 348 kilometers, and the consumption was only 203 watt-hour per kilometer. That's actually not too bad, considering this car is semi-thirsty, and yeah, it was dry outside, but actually quite windy. And then we came with 5% left, so it means that we have 366 kilometers of range, so slightly less than summer. And then, but the capacity, that's what we wanted to measure. Today we measured 74.4 kilowatt hour. And then last year I measured 72.8 kilowatt hours. So we actually have 1.6 kilowatt hour more. That is so much more significant that it's not just measurement error. So usually when I measure capacity, I can nail it down to almost the kilowatt hour. So this proves that it is correct that Polestar now has more available energy. It's a 78 kilowatt hour battery. Some of it is of course locked for use because it's braking protection, but yeah, so you get 1.6 kilowatt hour extra, and today that means 8 kilometers of extra range then. So just a small bonus, unlock a little bit on the bottom, but it's nice, yeah. And also another improvement they supposedly did with the software was that they improved the charging speed. And right now I'm charging and I'm not sure really. It did hit 150 kilowatt on the bottom, but it already throttled a little bit. So, but that will be covered in a separate video. So anyway, I think that's going to be it for now. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. As always, thank you for watching and talk to you later.